In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today in the Gospel, we hear two parables where Jesus explains what the kingdom of God is. Kingdom of God is here and now, alive and active, as we participate in this Mass. We feel the kingdom of God. We become the part of the kingdom of God. For the times we have failed to realize that we are the part of the kingdom of God, let us ask pardon from the Lord. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call the sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
He was seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Let us put forth all our intentions before the presence of the Lord. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, go and buy a linen lion cloth and put it round your waist, and do not dip it in water. So I bought a lion cloth according to the word of the Lord, and put it round my waist. And the word of the Lord came to me a second time, take the lion cloth that you have bought, which is round your waist, and arise, go to the Euphrates, and hide it there in a cleft of the rock. So I went and hid it by the Euphrates, as the Lord commanded me. And after many days, the Lord said to me, arise, go to the Euphrates, and take from there the lion cloth that I commanded you to hide there. Then I went to the Euphrates and dug, and I took the lion cloth from the place where I had hidden it. And behold, the lion cloth was spoiled. It was good for nothing. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Thus says the Lord, even so will I spoil the pride of Judah and the great pride of Jerusalem. This evil people who refuse to hear my words, who stubbornly follow their own heart and have gone after other gods to serve them and worship them, shall be like this lion cloth, which is good for nothing. For as the lion cloth clings to the waist of a man, so I made the whole house of Israel and the whole house of Judah cling to me, declares the Lord, that they might be for me a people, a name, a praise, and a glory. But they would not listen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You forgot the God who gave you birth. You forgot the God who gave you birth. You were unmindful of the rock that bore you. And you forgot the God who gave you birth. The Lord saw it and spurned them because of the provocation of his sons and his daughters. You forgot the God who gave you birth. And he said, I will hide my face from them. I will see what their end will be. For they are a perverse generation, children in whom is no faithfulness. You forgot the God who gave you birth. They have made me jealous with what is no God. They have provoked me to anger with their idols. So I will make them jealous with those who are no people. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. You forgot the God who gave you birth. Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Of his own will he brought us forth by the word of truth, that we should be kind of first fruits of his creatures.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus put another parable before them, saying, the kingdom of God is like a grain of mustard seed that a man took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it is larger than all the garden plants and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like leaven that a woman took and hid in 3 measures of flour, till it was all leavened. All these things Jesus said to the crowds in parables. Indeed, he said nothing to them without a parable. This was to fulfill that was spoken by the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter what has been hidden since the foundation of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, what is the kingdom of God? Who can explain better than Jesus? Who has seen, who has come from the kingdom, who has come down from heaven. To make the people understand what the kingdom of God is, Jesus makes use of the parables. Today we have two parables in the gospel. One is of the mustard seed, another is of the leaven of the yeast. Taking these two parables, what is the kingdom of God then? Is it a man who sows the seed, or the mustard seed itself, or the plant, or the nest, or the birds? Or in the other parable, taking the other parable into account, what is the kingdom of God? The woman, the leaven, the flour? What is it? Kingdom of God is not noun. It is verb. So let us get into some grammar today. Kingdom of God is not noun. Kingdom of God is the verb. Let me try to explain. Let us go into the first parable. The man sowed the seeds, and those seeds are mustard seeds. Neither the man nor the mustard seed are the kingdom of God for our reference today. But what becomes, the process of becoming, the process could be called the kingdom of God. Maybe that sowing is a generous act. That sowing could be called the kingdom of God. The secondly, the mustard seed falling into the ground breaks itself so that it can become a new plant. It can become a new life. That falling into the ground and breaking itself could be called the kingdom of God. That sacrifice. Sacrifice is the kingdom of God. Today, we all in a way are making sacrifice. So sacrifice is not helplessness. I don't go to the parties these days because we are in the lockdown period. We are quarantined in our houses. So I don't go for the parties. So that is not the sacrifice. That is a helplessness. So sacrifice is where you, like the gospel of yesterday, for the greater treasure, you make the sacrifices of smaller treasures that you cherish in your lives. So, sacrifice. Sacrifice is the kingdom of God. Coming to the plant. The seed which germinated grows day by day into a plant. So, neither the seed that is fallen into the ground nor the plant is the kingdom of God. But the process of becoming the seed into the plant is the kingdom of God. We don't notice it. It happens. That happening is called the kingdom of God. That growth from seed to the plant is called the kingdom of God. That gradual growth. Every day, if you have a desire to grow towards the better, that is the kingdom of God. And finally, plant, once it becomes big, it shelters the birds. Birds come and have their nest. That sheltering is the kingdom of God. Where after having realized the worth of sacrifice in your life, after having grown towards the good, you shelter the others. You reach out to the others. That is the kingdom of God. This is the same story. It is the same narration even for the second parable that we hear in the gospel today. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, I said, kingdom of God is not the noun. Kingdom of God is the verb. Every time we make a sacrifice to grow towards the good is the kingdom of God. We become the part of the kingdom of God. Any sacrifice that we make, any sacrifice, not out of helplessness, but with the desire to grow, expand ourselves towards the good, open our hearts so that we can experience the love of God and give the experience to the others, that is the kingdom of God. And then we become the part of the kingdom of God. Since the kingdom of God is the verb, let us realize that we need to become like the Lord. We are called to be like Christ. We call ourselves Christians. We bear the name of Christ so that we too can become like Christ, who taught us the value of kingdom of God, and we through our lives can teach the values of the kingdom of God. In other words, to summarize everything that I said, kingdom of God is the potency that we have. Potency that we have. We have that potency to become anything, especially to become good. Realizing that potency and trying to actualize is the real kingdom of God. We have the potency, my dear brothers and sisters, that is instilled into our hearts by the Lord Himself. Let us realize it day by day and try to become good so that we proclaim the kingdom of God through our words and deeds. Amen. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that the sacrifice you and me offer here on this altar may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip Neri our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, our chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
We are called to be the part of the kingdom of God. That's why we pray in the prayer, Our Father, thy kingdom come, praying for this grace that his kingdom may come in our day-to-day life, and may we be able to feel his kingdom. Let's pray the prayer taught by Jesus himself. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Behold him who taught us the values of the kingdom of God. Happy are we who are called to the supper of this Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memory of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.